Hello everyone. So today we'll be studying a very important topic called dental bleaching from endodontics. So to understand dental bleaching, we need to know the term dental stains or tooth discoloration. So what do you understand by dental stains? It's basically a discoloration or change in color of the tooth. So classification of dental stains, Nathu stains. This classification was divided into three categories, N1, N2 and N3. The first is the N1, which shows that tooth discoloration is same as the agent binding on the surface. The color of the tooth is same as that of the agent. That is the N1 classification of Nathu stains. Second is the N2. That is, tooth discoloration is different here. So the agent and the discoloration is different than color of the binding agent. Remember this. Then comes N3. So here the agent is colorless. Colorless compound called prechromogen. So prechromogen, this is colorless, binds to the tooth and that causes a discoloration. This is N3. So this is Nathu stains to classify the dental stains. Another classification of dental stain is based on the location where it occurs. So there are basically two types of dental stains based on the location. Number one, called the extrinsic stains, and number two is the intrinsic stains. Now extrinsic stain, as the name suggests, occurs on the external surface of the tooth, and they can be removed by the self-care methods such as brushing and flossing. So external surface of the tooth, that is known as extrinsic stains, when they are present on the external surface of the tooth. And when the stains are internal in nature or present inside the tooth, they are known as intrinsic stains, and they cannot be removed by the self-care methods. The other method of classifying the dental stains is by the source of origin, that is by the source. That could be number one, exogenous stains, and number two, endogenous stains. So what do you understand by the exogenous stains? Exogenous means the source originates outside the tooth. That is why it is called as exogenous. And they may cause any types of stain, like extrinsic discoloration or intrinsic discoloration. But the source is exo in nature, that is external or outside the tooth. That is why it is known as exogenous stains. Whereas endogenous stains, here the source is within the tooth. The source which causes discoloration is within the tooth. So they are always intrinsic and they are usually due to discolored dentine. So when the dentine gets discolored, the intrinsic discoloration is seen and it is reflected through the tooth. So this is how you can classify dental stains by source, exogenous and endogenous. Let's discuss the frequently asked question from the topic of dental bleaching. So most of the questions from dental bleaching you will see are based on the composition, the bleaching agent which is used, how much is the concentration. Let's look at the question. Night guard vital bleaching is done using. So the options will show you the bleaching agents which is used for the vital bleaching technique, that is night guard bleaching technique. So here the option is using A, Makin solution. No, this is not an option. Then H2O2 activated with thermo and photo, that is a technique, thermocatalytic technique, that is wrong option. Sodium perborate and H2O2, okay, this is used for the non-vital technique. So this is non-vital, this is also not the answer, because we are looking for the vital bleaching technique, in night guard vital bleaching technique. So last is 10 to 16% carbamide peroxide, which is the bleaching agent which is used for the night guard vital bleaching technique. So this is the answer.